السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh.
Lesson number 929. Let us carefully listen to this lesson regarding the month of Ramadan. This is the ninth lesson regarding the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, closer to the month of Ramadan, told Sahaba that the month of Ramadan has dawned upon us. It is a month where the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like torrential rain comes. Allah forgives sins, Allah accepts du'as. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at your competition. How do you compete with one another and vie with one another in gaining more and more ibadat and worship to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for us to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our good deeds. Wretched is that person who does not gain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month. This hadith is made mention of in Tabarani. This month of Ramadan, it's a great, unique and magnificent month. Within the 24 hours, there is a time where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely accepts a dua of an individual. In this time of the day and the night, there are many, many, many people that are saved from the fire of Jahannam. In this year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts du'as from those that are fasting. Different people have given different du'as. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar ibn As radiallahu an, at the time of breaking his fast, he would say, Allahumma inni as'aluka برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء أن تغفر لي. Sometimes Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will read the dua, يا واسع الفضل اغفر لي. The point is whether we read this dua or any other dua, but let us make a habit of making as many duas as we possibly can, so that at least one point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give us. And there's some poetry that Maulana has made mention, that the meaning of which is the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our shortcomings cannot even begin to imagine. Step by step Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving us, but we are oblivious of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if there is one thing that we want, O Allah, is that you give us the ability to find that road that leads unto you, so that we may meet you, O Allah. And this is the desire of our heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.